Good afternoon, everyone. This is Tube 87, and to those of you who are keeping the Sabbath today, I hope you're having a happy and a blessed Sabbath. Now, I'm going to start this study out with a question, and that question is, are we not all only human with faults and frailties about us? And the answer would be yes, a resounding yes. Now, in spite of that, how does any of us come to trust anyone about anything? Interesting question, but the answer is we all do, in spite of knowing that we all have faults, issues, or what have you. And this comes from belief. We have to believe and have faith in individuals to proceed forward in our lives in terms of doing anything. So we trust and have faith in individuals to accomplish things and to live a life of peace to some degree. Now, Scripture is no different. The individuals in Scripture, all those representative, Moses, Noah, Lot, whomever, they're all presented to us with all their faults and all their sins. Differently from us, their stuff is laid out in Scripture so that we can see that. But on top of that, we also get to see where they came from, how they overcame, repented, and moved on, did the Father's work to His glory, and hopefully to their blessings. This is all illustrated to us as an example, because Scripture could easily present all these individuals as faultless, but with that comes disbelief, or more disbelief. There are enough individuals now who don't believe Scripture based on all the facts that are laid out there. So there was a method, there was a reason, a rhyme and reason to everything being laid out that it is. So these individuals would be shown to us to be just human, but human individuals who overcame with the help of the Heavenly Father. Now I'm going to read something to you, and then I'm going to go on from there. The pen of inspiration, true to its text, tells us that the sins that overcame Noah, Lot, Moses, Abram, David, and Solomon, and that even Elijah's strong spirit sank under temptation during his fearful trial. Jonah's disobedience and Israel's idolatry are faithfully recorded. Peter's denial of Christ, the sharp contention of Paul and Barnabas, the failings and infirmities of the prophets and apostles are all laid bare by the Holy Ghost, who lifts the veil from the human heart. There before us lie the lives of the believers with all their faults and follies, which are intended as a lesson to all the generations following them. If it had been without foible, they would have been more than human, and our sinful natures would despair of ever reaching such a point of excellence. But seeing where they struggled and failed, where they took heart again and conquered, and led to press over the obstacles that degenerate nature places in our way. So it's illustrating, or it's telling us, that Scripture is written with a purpose and as a very good example that we can overcome, we can move forward, we can get by anything. But yet, this is telling us we can do all these things in spite of our faults, our sins, our issues. Now, one difference is that our sins, issues, and faults aren't laid out for everyone to see, nor do they need to be. See, individually, we have to work on these things, and we can accomplish this through repentance. We can accomplish this through having a strong faith, developing a strong faith and belief in the Word and what the Father tells us. Now, there are individuals all over who don't believe in the Word, who want to discredit the word, and those who would push it forward, those who would do the Father's work. The patriarchs of the past went through the same thing. It's all illustrated in Scripture. All their sins and everything is laid out there. Individuals tried to call out the Savior himself, the only perfect one. They tried to lay sins out there that he had done that didn't even exist. They created these lies. But yet, it shows us that they move forward from those, and in spite of the enemy trying to use individuals to do his work to discredit the Word by discrediting the individuals who are spreading the Word, is going to move forward anyway. Now, we go through the same thing today. There are individuals out here that will try and discredit any and everyone who is trying to do the Father's work. Now, I said all that to say this. We all, self-included, my wife included, my family included, we all have our own faults and our own sins, but we don't need to lay them out for the whole world to see. It's just enough to know and understand that we're all human. Now, some of us, in spite of our issues, in spite of our sins, in spite of our flaws, we push forward to do the Father's work while at the same time work on perfecting our character through repentance, through practice, through study, through all these things. It is a learning and growing experience. You're not going to accomplish this overnight. But in the meantime, need I walk around saying, well, I can't share the Word with other individuals because I'm not perfect. I'm not right yet. One day I'll get there and then I can spread the Father's Word. That's no different than individuals who refuse to get into the Word because they claim they're not ready yet. They have too much other worldly things or worldly stuff to do. So they put it off until they feel like they're going to be ready. I am, as well as everyone I know, we are who we are. But I'm not gonna let those things inhibit my ability. Thank the Father for blessing me with that and pushing me forward to help share his Word with anyone. Now, we're all human. We all have faults. Like I said, they don't need to be laid out there because that's all it would serve is as a reason to distract you. They may be minor to some or major to some, but whatever they are, as with each one of you, they're things that we all need to work on. We take these things to the Father. Remember, if it's not about an individual who you have an issue with that you need to go repair or fix, you can go straight to the Father and ask him to help you overcome your own weaknesses and frailties. That's what it's all about. Doing his will and working on yourself at the same time. See, all the perfect individuals out there, he doesn't need them. They're perfect in their own mind. All those out there who think they are perfect already, they don't even call on the Father. I know I need the Father. I call on him as often as possible, as well as my wife and the rest of my family. We know that we are but human with faults and frailties. So we're going to keep spreading his Word, and I pray and I have faith and trust in him now, and I hope that all of you, any of you, in spite of what your issues and faults are, you look forward and work forward to doing the Father's will. You can do it in spite of where you are in your life spiritually, and ask him to help you along the way, and he will bless you, help you to overcome and move forward into doing his work, whatever his work for you as an individual is. So, with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father does not call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful and obedient. This is Tube 87. I'm out.